Hey everyone, welcome to Man Cave Insider. I'm Dennis, thank you for joining me. If you like what you see, make sure you subscribe to our channel so you can see past and future videos. We are here in my man cave, and this room is filled with things that I've collected my entire life, and these are the stories behind them. And today, we're gonna be taking a look at the new 4K release from Arrow Video of Wes Craven's 1977 classic, The Hills Have Eyes. This film reignited the horror genre in the 70s that continued on to the 80s through today. Now, Wes Craven has been known as the master of horror ever since his first film, The Last House on the Left, and such films as Nightmare on Elm Street and the Scream series. The Hills Have Eyes was his third film, and the premise was a family traveling across country, getting lost in the desert, and their car breaking down, and they are stuck in the middle of nowhere and are terrorized by a cult of cannibals. The film was also written by Craven, and the story parallels Hansel and Gretel and is inspired by the legend of the Sawney Bean, the head of a Scottish clan allegedly responsible for the murder and cannibalism of over 1,000 people. The original title was Blood Relations, The Sun Wars, and was originally going to be set in New Jersey. Producer Peter Locke, whose girlfriend performed in Las Vegas, suggested moving the location of the film to the desert. The gritty look of the film was inspired by Craven's first film, The Last House on the Left, as well as the Texas Chainsaw Massacre. The production designer of both the Texas Chainsaw Massacre and The Hills Have Eyes was Robert Burns, who used many of the props from Texas Chainsaw in The Hills Have Eyes. Gunnar Hansen, who played the role of Leatherface, turned down a role in The Hills Have Eyes and later regretted it. Also starring in the film were Susan Lehner, Robert Houston, Martin Speer, Russ Grieve, Dee Wallace, and Michael Berryman. To achieve the gritty look of the film, it was shot on 16mm and was filmed in October of 1976 in Victorville, California, and the Mojave Desert. During the day in the desert, the temperature got as high as 120 degrees and went down to 30 degrees at night. And actor Michael Berryman was born without sweat glands and needed consistent medical attention while shooting the film during the day. The actors were paid minimum wage and the crew was non-union. Many of the members of the crew had also worked on several of Roger Corman's B films and were not very excited about working on The Hills Have Eyes. However, because of the enthusiasm of Wes Craven day in and day out, he won over the crew and they believed that they were making something very special. The film had a budget of around $700,000, and it was released in the summer of 1977 and grossed $25 million. The Hills Have Eyes 2 was also written and directed by Wes Craven and released in the summer of 1985 to poor reviews and little box office. The Hills Have Eyes was remade in 2006 by director Alexandra Aja, and it was produced by Wes Craven. A sequel followed 1 year later in 2007 that was written by Craven and his son, Jonathan. The Hills Have Eyes inspired a new generation of gritty horror films, such as 1978's Halloween, directed by John Carpenter, and Friday the 13th and Prom Night, both released in 1980. Craven would go on to direct many other horror films, such as the original Nightmare on Elm Street, Shocker, The People Under the Stairs, and the Scream series. The Hills Have Eyes also started a bit of a humorous rivalry between Wes Craven and director Sam Raimi. In The Hills Have Eyes, there was a torn poster of Jaws, which was meant to signify that Jaws was pop horror and The Hills Have Eyes was real horror. Raimi responded in his film The Evil Dead with a torn poster of The Hills Have Eyes to signify that The Evil Dead was real horror. Craven responded in The Nightmare on Elm Street by having a scene where they were watching The Evil Dead on television. Raimi responded in The Evil Dead 2 with Freddy's gloves seen on the wall in one of the scenes. And in the original Scream movie, there was a scene where the characters are deciding which horror film to watch, Halloween or The Evil Dead. Ultimately, they chose to watch Halloween. Now, what I have here is the new release sent to me by Arrow Video of The Hills Have Eyes, appearing on 4K for the very first time. It includes an alternate ending, several bonus features, postcards from the film, a reversible poster, and a book of essays on the film. So let's take a look at this new release. Okay, so here is Wes Craven's The Hills Have Eyes on 4K from Arrow Video. It comes in a box. And on the back of it, it's got a description of the film and a list of all of the bonus features that come in this package. It's got the new artwork on the front. Picture of the film on the back. This comes on one disc with the movie and all of the bonus features. And it's got some advertisement for some other releases coming up from Arrow Video. This also has reversible artwork. It comes with postcards, as this picture on the back of all of them. These are posters from other releases in different parts of the world. This also comes with a two-sided poster of the artwork featured on both sides of the 4K case. The last thing it comes with is this 40-page book of some essays about the film and about the restoration. As always, Arrow Video does an excellent job with all of these classic releases. You don't get things like this by watching the movie on a streaming service or downloading it. You know, it's great to have the movie on 4K. It looks better than it ever has before. It still has that gritty look because it was shot on 16 millimeter. And if you're a fan of Wes Craven's later work, Scream, Nightmare on Elm Street, you know, it's definitely worth going back to one of his original classics. So that is it for our look at The Hills Have Eyes on 4K. I want to thank Arrow Video for giving me the opportunity to review this amazing release. I'm going to put a description down below on where you can get this. Thank you for watching. Make sure you subscribe to our channel, and we look forward to seeing you next time.